Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making wasabi and green onion dip. So we're going to start with a little bowl here that has 4 tablespoons of snipped green onions, green onion tops in here, and I'm going to add sour cream. I have half this container left, so this is 1 cup of sour cream. And you may use the reduced fat variety, which is actually what I have here, the light, or regular sour cream. And I get a lot of people that for some reason don't like sour cream, or they can't get it, and they're always asking me what can I use in the place of it. I usually suggest plain yogurt because it has a little bit of tartness to it and it replaces sour cream and dips pretty well. And then we're going to add some wasabi paste. Right here in this little container is wasabi paste, and this is something that might be compared to horseradish because it's very strong in flavor. It's a different plant from horseradish, so it's not that, but expect it to be very flavorful if you've not tried it before. I'm putting in 1½ teaspoons of wasabi paste. That's 1½ tablespoon. And it's nice if you go ahead and spray your measuring spoon with cooking oil spray so that that will just drop right out. And then mix that in. And then your wasabi paste, you store back in the refrigerator. Now, what has happened here is we have a nice dip. We're going to season it with salt and pepper, but you'll notice that it is a very pale green, and it's not that vivid color that you usually expect of a wasabi type dip. So we're going to put some food coloring in also. So I'm going to get my coarse ground salt and then fresh black peppercorns, grind those. And then I have some regular green food coloring, and you'll see that you have this nice emerald color, and that's more what you expect to see in a wasabi and green onion dip. So this is finished. I'll accept the tasting. You might want to taste this for salt and pepper, also for the amount of wasabi paste in there. You might want to step it up a little bit. For people who really like it, 2 teaspoons would be fine. If you've never tried it and are just experimenting, I would say just use 1 teaspoon. You can always adjust upward. So this is it, and then we're going to serve it today with some crackers. Now these are from this box, Townhouse Pretzel Thins, and I thought the pretzel flavor would be good with the wasabi and green onion. I will be having something for you in the next video that you can dip into your wasabi and green onion dip. But for now, I'm just putting it in a central bowl surrounded by our pretzel thins. Now, you'll notice that I have some milk sitting here. If the texture of this had been a little thick, then I would thin it with milk. So I just put it out to remind me to tell you that. So here is the dip that I'm going to take a taste of. And I'm just putting a small amount on the pretzel thin because it's a very strong flavor in the wasabi part of this dip. So I've got my little place here, and I have a Diet Coke to go with it. And we'll take this one, and I'm just going to taste of the dip. Very hot, gets your attention. It's really nice to serve if you have something bland for it to go on, like pretzel generally don't have that much flavor, but they have a good combined flavor with the wasabi and green onion. Now I'm going to take a taste of the pretzel and the dip. Mmm,
Really good combination. I'm going to be posting this as a possibility for Super Bowl party because it is something that I think people will enjoy. It's very easy to make, so quick, and you can get whatever type of dippers you want to go with it. Hope you enjoy this recipe.